Thank you. Objection! Thank you. Objection!
Order! Order! Witness, is that true?
This amounts to nothing more than conjecture. I do not believe you have any solid proof. However, I have to concede that you have surmised a logical connection between me and the missing magic gem. Consequently, I am prepared to answer your questions.
Good. I will repeat what I asked you previously. Witness, state your name, profession, and finally, your gender.
My name is Jean Grail. I have been serving the late Master Belduke. As you can see, I wear a butler's outfit, but the truth is, as the defense claims, I am a girl.
A girl? Unbelievable.
What? The butler is a girl?
Thank you.
Objection!
Thank you. Is gonna outwit you in court. You're an ace attorney after all. So, let's do it!
Objection!
For Emir's grand entrance. Did you miss me, guys?
Order! Order! Could it be that it was you who...
Where are you looking, old man? I'm right here. And as for who I am... I'm the alchemist's neighbor and a witness in that case, too!
Objection! Objection! Objection!
Objection!
Objection!
Objection!
Objection!
Thank you.
Objection!
Thank you. He's absolutely certainly talking about me.
Oh, and you are?
Oh, I'm Letty. Hang on a minute. I'll get down there post-haste.
But, Miss Letty, who are you precisely?
Me? Who am I? I'm Letty Mailer. I'm the courier.
Objection!
Objection! Objection!
Thank you.
Objection!
Objection! Thank you.
Objection!
Thank you.
Objection! Objection!
Objection!
Objection! Thank you.
You can stay here, but from now on, you must live as a boy.
Thank you. Thank you.
Objection! 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 Objection!
Objection!
Thank you.
Objection! Objection!
Objection!
Thank you. Miss Grayer, I think you should be the one to read it.
Me?
Sir Belduke wrote this letter to the storyteller as he was preparing to die. I think it's only right his last words should be read by you.
Yes, you're right. I see. I understand. Please allow me to read the letter aloud. My dear friend, I hope you will be able to forgive me for leaving this world of my own will. I have finally made this decision, having seen that accursed bell tower
appear in the flames on that dreadful night. That lightning was a sign that we have angered the gods. What I have done cannot be forgiven. I can never escape from it. For the past few days, I have been thinking that it might be best to simply expose everything. This town's secret, the truth about the witch. Of course, I understand that secrets need to be kept. However, I have grown very tired. I'm afraid I cannot keep the secret any longer. I have only two concerns. The first is my daughter. It pains me to be leaving her alone in this world, although she probably doesn't think of me as her father.
A daughter?
I was not aware that Sir Belduke had a daughter.
Mr. Belduke seemed to know a lot about this town. This town's secret, and the truth about the witch.
Truth about the witch? Somehow I don't think he was talking about Miss Grayer.
Oh. The second matter, weighing heavily on my mind, is that Jean will be left on her own.
Seeing her growing up, so strong and righteous, in defiance of her fate, had given me hope. A short while ago, she brought me my usual, and what will be my last, drink. There are so many things I wanted to tell her, but I could only manage a thank you. She is a very sharp child. Had I said any more, she would have caught on. You could call me a selfish man, but I didn't wish my last memory of her to be a sad one.
Master Belduke. If the fate handed to her by this town has made her life an ordeal until now, I hope from the bottom of my heart that a wonderful story awaits her next. I intend to leave my residence to her. And I would like you to look out for her.
Alas, it is time for me to put my pen down. My dear friend, what I truly wish to express to you is too complicated for words. I hope one day you will understand. But for now, I bid you farewell. The time has come for me to go.
This letter. It wasn't a denunciation of me being a witch.
Master Belduke cared about you until the very end.
Yes, how could I have forgotten? I'm sure I knew it all along. So why did I? How could I have done that to him?
Thank you.
What is it now, Espella Cantabella?
There is nothing else we can do. This is the course of things, and you should know it well.
Indeed. All witches shall be cast into the flames. That is the law of this town. A law that was written by your very own father. And furthermore, a law that has always been obeyed in the town of Labyrinthia.
A town like this should never exist in the first place.
What such insolence?
That's heresy. She's criticizing the storyteller's story. Even the storyteller's daughter has no right to criticize the story.
Trials in which innocent people are sentenced to death by fire. I shall make sure this is the last one.
What do you mean, Espella?
Since you're also keen on the rules created by the storyteller, you should know exactly what I mean. The stipulation for ending the witch trials. Once the great witch Bazella is burned, the witch trials will end. At present, I am under suspicion. You know very well why that is, don't you?
You? Well, you don't mean that you're,
I am guilty. I am the Great Witch Bazella.
What?
Now, cast me into the flames and let Miss Grail free.
Miss Cantabella.
This shall be the last of the witch trials. No one else need be burned hereafter.
Espella, just what are you saying? I can't let you do that.
Please, Mr. Wright, let me do as I wish. I'm sorry, but this is a problem concerning the people of Labyrinthia.
No! Please don't do it!
There must be another way! You don't need to do this!
It's all right. Luke, Maya, Mr. Wright, and Mr. Layton, I truly appreciate all you have done for me.
This can't be happening!
Miss Cantabella, your confession will have very serious, or rather, fatal consequences for you. May we assume that you fully understand those consequences and are willing to accept them?
I am Espella Cantabella, the storyteller's daughter. But I also have another name. I am the Great Witch Bazella. I have lived hidden in the dark pages of my father's story, deceiving all of you. Many lives have been sacrificed because of me. But that shall end today.
Court attendants, seize that woman! She is the Great Witch, Bazella.
Espella.
Stop!